Good morning to everyone. Today we are going to learn new exercise 2.5, radical notation. Okay, radical notation. Let n be a positive integer, r be a real number. If r to the power of n equal to x, then r is called the nth root of x, and we write nth root of x equal to r. Nth root of x equal to r. It's clear, children? The symbol is this is the symbol. Okay, symbol is nth root, read as nth root, is called a radical. Okay, and n is the index of the radical. Okay, and x is called the radicand. Okay, nth root of x, how we have to receive this? N is what? Root index is n. Okay, and this symbol is radical symbol, and x is radicand. S is what? Radicand. And this r is number. Okay, that is how we have to receive nth root of x can be written as x to the power of 1 by n. Same way, example, if you take cube root of 64, how you can write means, you put 64 here, instead of 3, you put 1 by 3. It's clear, children? This is this. And same way, if it is 25, so here, no, that means this is root 2. So you can write 25 power 1 by 2. Right, children? Now we'll see some more example. Power, radical notation, index notation, how you're going to read as. Okay, so 64 is there. The 64 in powers, how you can write? Very simple, children. See here, 64 factorize. 2 how many times? 2, 3 is 6, 2 times. 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 8s are 16, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are, okay. 64 can be written as 2 to the power of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2 to the power of 6. So 64 can be written as 2 to the power of 6. This is power. It's clear, children? Power. 64 can be written as 2 to the power. Now radical notation. Radical notation. How you can write radical notation? Very simple, children. We know that. See, now 2 power 6 equal to 64. Right? 2 power 6 equal to 64. How we can write as radical notation means 2 equal to 664. Okay, understood, children? Very simple. See, children, power you can write 64 equal to 2 to the power of 6, right? 64 equal to 2 to the power of 6. Okay, now radical, you have to write in the form of radical notation. See, children, 64 equal to 2 to the power of 6. Okay, 2 to the power of 6 equal to 64. 2 to the power of 6 equal to 64. Okay. Now, 2 can be written as 64 whole power 1 by 6. 2 power 6 can be written as 64 the whole power 1 by 6. Now, see, children. Now 2 equal to this 1 by, that is x to the power of 1 by n can be written as nth root of x. Same way, 64 the whole power of 1 by 6 can be written as 6th root of 64. It's clear, children? Now this is radical notation. Okay, now I can write here 2 equal to 6 of 64. Same way, now index notation, this is the index. Index means what? Power. Okay, 64 to the power 1 by 6. 2 equal to 64 to the power of 1 by 6. Okay, so you can read as 2 is the 6th root of 64. We can see one more example, children. Now next is 32 is the. So you can write 32. So you can write 32 when you factorize. 2 1s are 2, carry 1, 2 6 are 12, right? 2 how many times? 8 times. 2 how many times? 4 times. 2 how many times? 2 times. 32 can be written as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2 to the power of 5. right? 32 can be written as 2 to the power of 5, right? Now I have to write into radical notation, right? See, 2 to the power of 5 equal to 32. 2 equal to 32 to the power of 1 by 5. So 2 equal to 5th root of 32, right? Now 2 equal to 5th root of 32. It's clear, children? Next, you have to write in the form of index notation. Write in the form of index notation. So index notation is nothing but 32 power 1 by 5 equal to 2. You write 2 equal to 32 to the power of 1 by 5. So you can read as, 2 is the 5th root of 32. You have some more example in page number 58. So go through this sum, children. If any doubts, you can ask. It's clear, children? This is not all very easy. Now we can see exercise problem.
Exercise 2.5. Write the following in the form of 5 to the power of n. The given number is 625. You have to write in the form of 5 to the power of n. Solution. 625, right? First factorize. 625. You can factorize by 5. 5 ones are 5. Carry 1. That means 12. 5 2s are 10, right? Next, 5 1s are 5, carry 1, 5 2s are 10, carry 2, 5 5s are 25. Again 5, 5 2s are 10, carry 2, 5 5s are 25. Again 5, 5s are 25. Now 625 can be written as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to the power of 4. 625 can be written as 5 to the power of 4. So 625 equal to 5 to the power of 4. Actually, you have to write in the form of 5 to the power. It is in the form of 5 to the power of n. It's clear, children? Now, second sum, second subdivision. Second subdivision is what? 1 to the power 1 divided by 5. Solution. 1 divided by 5. You have to make in the form of 5 to the power of n. But here 1 to the power of 5. We know that 1 by a to the power of n can be written as a to the power plus m will change as minus m. Okay. So denominator, numerator 1 is there. Denominator a power m is there. This denominator a power n, when you bring it into numerator, plus m become minus m. Same way 1 by 5 is there. This 1 by 5, you can write 5 to the power of, here 1 is the row, so minus 1. Now it is the form of 5 to the power of n. Okay, this is the solution. Next, third subdivision. Third subdivision is what? Root 5. Third subdivision is root 5. Right, solution. Root 5. Root 5 can be written as 5 to the power of 1 by 2. So it is in the form of 5 to the power of n. 5 to the power of n. So 5 power 1 by 2. And fourth subdivision is root of 125. Fourth subdivision is what? Root of 125. Okay, first factorize 125. So 5 2s are 10, balance 2, 5 5s are 25. 5 25 times. So root of 125 can be written as square root of 5 cube. Root of 125 can be written as 5 cube, right, children? Now see 5 cube as it is, that is root of x can be written as x to the power of 1 by 2. Same way root of x, so x to the power of 1 by 2. That is in the form of a power m the whole power n. You can write a power m into n. So 5 power 3 by 2. So it's clear, children? This is the answer, right? 2.5, question number 2. Write the following is in the form of 4 to the power of n. First one, 16 is given. So solution 16. You have to make in the form of 4 to the power of n. So 16 can be factorized as 4 4s are 16. So 16 is equal to 4 to the power of 2. 16 can be written as 4 to the power of 2. Next, second subdivision, 8. 8 can be written as 2
4s are 8. Okay. But you have to make in the form of 4 to the power of n. Here 4 is there, here 2 is there. Okay. So 8 can be written as 2 into 4. Right. 2 into 4. Right. Already 4 is there. It's not a problem. This 2, how we can make means 2 can be written as. 2 can be written as 2 power whole power 2 and 1 power 2. See. When multiply a power m, the whole power n can be written as a power m into n. Same way, 2 can be written as, that is 2 power 2, 1 by 2 can be written as 2. Okay, 2 into 1 by 2, that is equal to 2. Right, so 2 can be written as, you need what, 4. You need this, we need it as 4, so that you are taking square. Here 2 means here 1 by 2, right? You can write like this. Now, in the place of 2, you can write 2 power 2, the whole power 1 by 4. Sorry, 1 by 2, whole power 1 by 2, right? Again, I will write here, children. In the place of 2, you can write 2 power 2, the whole power 1 by 2 into 4, right? Now, 2 squared is what? 4. The whole power 1 by 2 into 4, your power is 1. A power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. So I can write it as 4 to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1. Take LCM. 4 to the power of 1 plus 2 by 2, that is equal to 4 to the power of 3 by 2. So it is in the form of 4 to the power of n. This is the solution, children, 4 to the power of 3 by 2. Now, third subdivision is 32. Third subdivision is what? 32. Now, I have to make in the form of 4 to the power of n. So, how you can make 32? First, you factorize with 4. 4 8s are 32. 4 8s are 32. It's clear. 4 2s are 8. 32 can be written as 4 into 2. 4 into 4, 4 squared. Same way here, I want 2 as 4. So 2 can be written as 2 squared the whole power 1 by 2. That is equal to 2 to the power of 1 by 2. That is equal to 4 to the power of 1 by 2. So I can write 2 as 4 to the power of 1 by 2. So, it is in the form of a to the power of m into a to the power of n. A to the power of m plus n. So, 4 to the power of 2 plus 1 by 2. 4 to the power of 2. 2s are 4. 4 plus 1, 5 by 2. Right? So, this is the solution, children. This is third sum. So, we have completed second one.